Okay, to find my images, I just go through magazines and look for stuff that I would like to see on a piece of tape. Remembering that your tape is not very wide. So I'll just go through here and pick out some stuff, and then we'll cut it to size and then put it, the tape on it. Here are a few of the things that I clipped out. You can do food, animals. I like vintage photos. I like people with glasses on. You can use words. I like this word grouping there. I'm gonna use that. I'm not sure if I'm gonna do the glasses or the lips. I like this whole thing here. And I like the balloons or the image. I like, kind of like that a little bit, or the words. I love this big eye. All these flowers. And this is cool. Either the glasses, probably the glasses, yeah. And then this is a vintage photo. I kind of like that. So, let's get started. Oh, and I would recommend you leaving them on the page, the big page. So they won't get stuck to things around if you make cut them small like I did with these little ones here. Okay, then you get your tape and cut it to the size you want, or thereabouts. Making sure you lay it down as flat as you can. See, mine got a bubble in it. That's okay. Then you use your bone folder. You can use a spoon, any flat object. And you rub. Rub, rub, rub. You can see it when the paper makes good contact with the tape. If you tip it a little bit, you can tell. And then you take a scissor and you cut right along your tape edge. And cut off what you don't want to be on your tape. So get ready for putting in the water, soaking it in the water before we peel off the backing, the magazine page. Okay, let's do another one. Let's do this one. Kind of like those, I forget what they call those. Macaroons, I guess they're called. Okay. You just rub. Again, you just rub, 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 rub. The more you rub, the more the contact makes with tape contacts with the ink, the more of a better print you're going to get. Now, you may not want a better print. Some prints look better when they're only partially, you know, picked up by the tape. And I'll show you another way to get that look. Okay, once again, we'll trim. I'm going to do a few more of these off camera, and then I'll show you how we get them apart from the tape to use in our collage. Here's the ones that I came up with. It's a vintage photo. I like her pose. Here's an animal, giraffe. I like the animal pictures. Here's a interesting lips. Balloons, big eye, like eyes. Here's one with glasses, sunglasses. And I found these beautiful roses. That'll make a beautiful tape. Words, food, macaroons. Audrey Hepburn all dressed up. I like that one. Here's some more words and sunglasses. So we'll go on to the next step. Next step is you get a bowl of warm water and you just start putting your tapes in. And then we're going to let this soak for a half hour, 45 minutes. The longer is fine too, it doesn't really matter. The longer they sit, the easier the paper will come off. Okay, now we're ready to take the paper off. Some of it already came off. This one is completely off. You have a nice transparent picture of roses. These are coming off easier than I remembered. It slides right off. Look at that. Wow, that's great. I used to have to rub it. There's some glasses. Here's another one. The macaroons came out really cool. This is the words. If there's paper left on, you just rub it off. It's pretty easy. Big eye. I just love the way these are transparent. So whatever you put behind them will show through. Makes it cool. Here's another word grouping. There's the lips. This giraffe one with the lady reaching up. I like that one. I like this lady's pose. The back came off already. I like this pink hair. All these will make, you can stitch them on, you can make cards, all kinds of stuff, and you know, I'm sure you all have great ideas for that part. Here's that one of Audrey Hepburn. It came out really good. Glasses. There's a vintage photo. And all of these came out of the magazine. Now what I would do is just spread them out probably, that doesn't matter, I don't think. Spread them out on something to dry. I'm using a towel here, but you could use whatever, paper towels or whatever. Then you can just take a little paper towel, dry off the excess, and then, or just let them sit for a while to completely dry. And then they can use them as you wish. It's pretty easy. Pretty, pretty easy. And lots of fun. I think I turn these over and dry the underside as well. Now, another way I store them is on a page protector, because these things still are sticky and they will get stuck on if you get papers near them once they dry. So I stick them on a page protector, and I think I've got one here. This is the ones from before. I pulled off several, but I noticed when I pulled them off it took off more of the image, which made them look even cooler. And this is one that's been on there for quite some time, I'd say a year or more. It looks stuck, but actually it is stuck, but I mean it'll, when it comes off, it pulls off some of the ink, more of the ink, and then you get this really cool distressed look that I like. Well, that wouldn't have been there if it hadn't sat on that protector sheet for a while. Now here is another one. Here's one with a rose on it. Hard part is getting it started. Hurt to turn up a corner, bend a corner under when you store them like this for that reason. And that's what it's hard to see the image because there's one behind it as well. I store them on both sides. Hard to see, but on the right background, that'll be really pretty. It's a rose. See what I mean? They're still sticky, so that's why it's best to store them on something plastic that you can not get stuck to your other stuff. On the inside, but there's another one with one stuck to it. There gives it kind of a distressed look. Anyway, that's how you do tape transfers. They're pretty easy. And you can use most any magazine. I've used several different ones, and they all work pretty much the same. All right, thank you for watching.